Yo, what is going on, you incorrect NK? I know I haven't uploaded a video in a little while, but kind of taking a little bit of a break from the PTCGO in general. Everything's a little bit stale, a little bit played out right now. I've still been playing a little bit. I played in a tournament the other day on the stream where I've also been playing a ton of Pokemon Unite. So if you guys want to catch me playing some Pokemon Unite, as well as still playing some PTCGO over there, check out the live stream as always, twitch.tv/AzulGG. First link in the description, give it a click, give it a follow. So today we're gonna take a look at the new fusion Pokemon that were just leaked over in Japan, or leaked to us from Japan, whatever you want to say. And it's basically just kind of a stamp on a card that says it basically combos with other cards that have the same stamp. It's similar to Single Strike and Rapid Strike. They're not really like a new mechanic. It's just kind of like a way that other cards can be labeled to interact with each other more cleanly. So it's the fusion cards, very similar to Single Strike and Rapid Strike. First one we're gonna take a look at is this Mew V. It's got that energy mix attack for one. Psychic search deck for an energy, attached to one of your fusion Pokemon, then shuffle your deck. And then it's got that Psycho Jump for 70. You may shuffle this Pokemon all cards attached to it into your deck. It's got that 180 HP. So as a V becoming a VMAX, not really that big of a deal as what's on the V. It's like nothing game breaking or anything, but some nice useful attacks to potentially utilize in specific situations. You probably won't utilize either of these attacks very often. But of course, the Mew VMAX fusion is the big card here for us to take a look at, with that cross fusion colorless colors. And this is the big attack on this Pokemon that'll make it viable as long as there's enough other good fusion Pokemon, because for this cross fusion attack, you choose an attack from one of your bench fusion Pokemon and use it as this attack for two colorless energy. So you can kind of cheat the energy cost a little bit. You can play whatever energy you want on this and then utilize any attack for, you know, whatever energy. It could be like 10 fire energy. You just need double colorless to use that attack as long as it is a fusion Pokemon. And then it has Psychic for the max miracle, 130. Damage from this attack isn't affected by any effects on your opponent's active Pokemon, so it can get through stuff like Decidueye, which is always a useful attack to have around. But yeah, cross fusion is definitely the main attack we want to look at here on the Mew VMAX. But that's not all that's going to make this card viable. You really need those other good fusion Pokemon around, because you're going to be utilizing those attacks through the cross fusion. So let's take a look at some of those, and they are pretty decent. First one is this Hoopa V. It's got that ability Double Phase. So as long as Pokemon is in play, it's both Psychic and Dark, which is always a nice ability to have to take advantage of some, you know, typing situations. How good will this card actually be on its own? I don't think it'll be great. It's got that Shadow Impact for Dark colorless. It also has 220 HP. It does 170. Put 3 damage counters on one of your opponent's Pokemon. But I think mostly this will be being utilized through, once again, that Mew VMAX. For two colorless, it can use this attack that costs Dark colorless, and you know, just use the attack as the Mew instead of the Hoopa. So I think you're just gonna be, if you're gonna be attacking with the Hoopa, it's just gonna be through the Mew. The Mew also has free retreat cost as well, something I didn't mention, which is just always kind of broken. So that makes me think the best way to kind of play the Mew will be actually with this Genesect. So this Genesect is actually just insane for the fusion Pokemon in general. It's got that fusion system ability. Once in your turn before you attack, you may draw cards from your deck until the number of cards in your hand equals the number of fusion Pokemon you have in play. So if you have 6 fusion Pokemon in play, 5 on the bench, 1 in the active, you can use the fusion system ability. And if you have 1 card in hand, you can draw 5. And then if another Genesect in play, so it's not limited to once per turn, or only one fusion system per turn, you can play down 6 cards and then draw 6 more cards. So the Genesect is kind of insane as a draw support for, I don't know, any kind of deck. This is kind of absurd. Obviously, it's going to be working with fusion Pokemon because that's what it's in. But yeah, the Genesect is insane. And it's got that attack metal colorless, 210. You can't use the attack during your next turn, but if you utilize it through Mew VMAX and you have 2 Mew VMAXes set up, you could have that free retreat. You just pivot between them, 210 over and over and over again, taking those big hits and big knockouts. Also, 210 is a great number to hit for, because a lot of the Vs that become VMAXes have around 210 HP. And there's another card coming up that allows us to increase our damage of our fusion Pokemon to be able to get up to like those 220s, like the Urshifu V has 220, stuff like that. So some of them have 220, a lot of them have 210 or less. So getting that number right there, that 210 number, is a big number to be hitting, to be getting knockouts on Vs before they become VMAXs, and really have like an extra way to kind of pressure your opponent early on. Next up, we have this Oracorio with that Fervent Lesson, 90 HP, basic Pokemon. As long as Pokemon is in play, your fusion Pokemon take 20 less damage from opponent's attack. So this will be very meta and format dependent. If there's matchups that this lines up really well into to reduce the 20 damage, then you'll be playing it. If not, you won't. So it'll just be like, either it will be included or won't. You can't have multiple in play at once. If you could play down like 2 of these, I'm sure you'd probably be including 2 or 3 of these in all your fusion decks, all your Mew VMAX fusion decks anyways, to really reduce that damage you're taking, make it really hard for your opponent to take those knockouts. But It really depends on the format and the meta. If it doesn't line up very well in the format or the meta, you just won't play it because it won't make a difference. So it really will just be dependent on that. And it's got that Fire Colorless Passionate Drop. Put 5 damage charge on your opponent's Pokemon in any way you like. So a decent attack as well in there that won't be too difficult to set up. It's only 2 energy, and there is that Fusion Energy coming out that is basically a Rainbow Energy for Fusion Pokemon. We got the Clamperl, and we'll get to that in a little bit. Clamperl here, which is kind of irrelevant, but it does become the Huntail and the Gormice. I think I'm saying that correct. I'm actually not sure. Huntail, as long as this Pokemon is in play, your opponent's single strike Pokemon require 1 more energy to use attack. So this is kind of a bench sitter stage 1 here. It's got 110 HP, and then its attack is Water Colorless Colorless, so nothing to write home about for the attack. And then, but the single strike jammer is really what you're looking at here. Single strike Pokemon currently aren't very good, but you know, this is the 2 or 3 sets away, and rotation will get involved as well. So who knows where single strike will be by the time this card comes out. They could be very good, and you might be wanting to include the Huntail in your deck to help against those single strike matchups. Once again, single strike as of right now isn't very good. Nothing really shows that it's going to get that much better as the format continues, besides maybe that Gengar VMAX whenever we get that. But who knows if that'll be good once again by the time Huntail gets released. So I'm just gonna have to wait and see where single strike is. One thing that is more likely to probably be good is Rapid Strike and the Gorbice with that Rapid Strike Canceler ability. As long as this Pokemon is in play, your opponent's Rapid Strike Pokemon have no ability. So it's shutting down Octillery. And the more important thing is you're shutting down that Quick Shooting from the Rapid Strike Inteleon. That not only does Rapid Strike Urshifu play off very often, but so does a lot of other decks. A lot of other decks are on that Inteleon engine. I think the Inteleon engine will be around for a while, so this Gorbice could be very powerful to include in your decks to just kind of shut down those quick shooting pings just completely, unless they take out your Gorbice, which once again is just a 1 prize Pokemon you're giving up there, so you don't really mind probably giving that up and letting your opponent take that knockout. So this could be a very strong card to include. Just really depends on where the format and where the meta is when it releases, but the way things are trending, Inteleon will probably still be around by the time this releases. Up next, we got the Toxel, which, like the Clamperl, is just an evolution into the Toxtricity, 120 HP, the max downer ability. It only works if you only have only fusion Pokemon in play. As long as Toxtricity is in play, the HP of your opponent's VMAX Pokemon is 30 less. So basically, just reducing that HP of your opponent's Pokemon, making it a little bit easier to take a knockout or 2-hit KO, something like that. We'll have to see. Once again, this is kind of meta dependent, format dependent, like how much are you hitting for? Can you actually get to like big 1-hit KOs because they have 30 less HP? It's still like, if you look at the numbers, like if it's got 320, it goes down to 290. Can you do 290 damage in 1 hit, or are you doing like 150, 140, or 2 150s? And this is like basically like a little bit of a boost for your fusion Pokemon, because we also have another fusion card coming out that increases our damage, so that might just be a better play than something like this Toxtricity. But we'll have to wait and see. You never know for sure. And it's got lightning colors for that 90 damage, which is, you know, once again, nothing to write home about. And then we got the Dreepy Dracloak that evolve into the Dragapult, which I'm super excited for, and I don't know if it'll be very good, of course, but it's got the 150 HP, stage 2, of course, but it's got that Fusion Assault for just 1 Psychic Energy, 30 damage times the number of Fusion Pokemon you have in play. So you're hitting for, you know, 180. If you got 5 on the bench plus the Dragapult in the active, 180 plus 180, you're hitting twice, basically doing 360 damage over 2 attacks, potentially, and that's way more HP than most VMAXs, so you can even skimp a little bit on one turn and still get away with a big 1-hit or a 2-hit KO, potentially. So, yeah, the Dragapult basically 2-hit KOing every VMAX in the format, and then 1-hit KOing some Vs when you combo it with the tablet, which we'll get to in just a second. Next up, we have the Meloetta for Psychic Colorless, 70 damage attack to 70 damage times the number of fusion energy attached to your Pokemon. And it's a basic, it only has 90 HP. This could be a fairly powerful attack, but I just don't see you getting 4 fusion energy in play all at once consistently to ever be able to utilize this card. So I don't think Meloetta is going to be very good. Seems like it's a little bit too costly to get the max value out of it, but we're gonna have to wait and see for sure. Maybe it's gonna be a little bit easier than I think. We don't know all of the fusion cards that are we don't know all the fusion cards yet. This is just like some of them. So if there's more stuff that can make and kind of combo with Meloetta, make Meloetta that much better in some ways, then we could see Meloetta being pretty decent. We'll have to see, but I'm not holding out hope on this one, nor am I holding out hope for the second one or the next one, which is Smeargle with that Trash Sketch for a colorless, 70 HP basic. Choose 2 fusion trainer cards from your opponent's discard pile, show them to your opponent, and put them into your hand. It just seems like this is too slow. Now the main card you could look to maybe recycle with this would be this Power Tablet, which we'll get into in just a second, but you're kind of just like wasting a turn to not do damage to get back stuff that does damage, which just seems kind of irrelevant. And then colors for 80, obviously not great. So we got the Sparkle here, Alyssa Sparkle. Choose two of your fusion Elsa Sparkle. Choose two of your fusion Pokemon and play for each Pokemon you chose. Search deck for a fusion energy attached to that Pokemon. So Elsa Sparkle, obviously you can combo very well with Meloetta, but it seems like it's just gonna be too situational to have to find the Sparkle and then use it while you also have Meloetta plus access to all four of your fusion energy to make the Meloetta actually hit hard enough. And then you're using your support for the turn on the Sparkle, which just seems kind of subpar. And with no like supporter search, it's gonna be hard to find it when you need it to utilize it. So just don't see this card being great. Which means if this card's not great, then Meloetta is probably not great as well, right? So don't see that working out. Then we have Chili, Silent, and Cress supporter. Search your deck for up to three fusion Pokemon, reveal them, and put them into your hand, then shuffle your deck. So I actually think this card could be really, really good. Usually not a huge fan of Pokemon search supporters because they're just a little bit too slow most of the time. But because of that Genesect V being kind of your draw support to follow up to it, if you play this card and get three basic Pokemon, one of them being a Genesect, and you already had like one to three other Pokemon in play, all of a sudden you can just draw cards with Genesect for your turn, or even get double Genesect off of this card, and then you're kind of just chilling, right? So that becomes your draw support for the turn, and this finds your Pokemon. So this with like the Dragapult, I could see being really, really, really good, because you find like your Dragapult, maybe you candy one out, GP into Dragapult, you get a Genesect, you get another GP, draw some cards, and you just kind of go from there. So I could see this card actually being really, really strong because it combos so well with the Genesect to actually give you some draw support for the turn to back you going and searching out your Pokemon. So this one I actually really, really like, and I think because of Genesect, this will be a very powerful card in fusion decks, and we'll just really have to wait and see how good fusion decks are. But yeah, we've seen very few fusion cards so far, so there's still a lot to see for fusion cards, hopefully, and then that might change stuff up as well, and hopefully see some more potential for archetypes, because right now we kind of just see Dragapult and Mew. But hopefully as we see more fusion cards, there's more potential for more different kinds of fusion archetypes, because right now it's just like that Dragapult and the Mew VMAX. All right, Power Tablet, 30 more damage. Your fusion Pokemon do 30 more damage to your opponent's active Pokemon. So effectively, it's an E-Power for fusion Pokemon, triple plus power, whatever you want to call it. So yeah, fusion Pokemon can be doing a lot of damage, but it's a little bit awkward because when we look at some of the attacks we currently have access to, if you look at, I mean, let's just say the Mew copying Genesect, that does 210 damage. But when we're looking at a format where VMAXs are involved, the 210 already kind of gets us the KOs on most Vs. Sure, some have 220, so maybe you can play down a tablet to get the KOs on the 220s. But to really get a 1-hit KO on a VMAX requires a lot. I guess if you play down three of them and you had the Toxtricity in play, it's definitely possible. But it definitely seems like you're working for a lot there. But it might be worth playing it to try and play for one of those big 1-hit KO turns. We'll have to wait and see how everything goes. Of course, you can play down four of them at once, and that would get you the 1-hit KO as well. So it might be worth it to play these. It also might just not ever line up great with how your math works out, and you're going to be end up 2-hit KOing them even when you're playing some of these down. So it's just not worth to play the Power Tablets. Yeah, once again, it's going to be one of those things where we have to wait and see what other fusion cards do we have. How much damage can we really hit for with these Power Tablets? Because if we can get easily to those that 320 number, which seems to be the main number to try and get to, if we can easily get to like that 320 number, then I can definitely see Power Tablet being a very, very powerful card and definitely played in pretty much all fusion decks. But it really depends on what numbers are we hitting, what numbers are we trying to hit, what is actually good when this card releases. Probably going to be VMAX Pokemon, which means we're looking at, if we're trying to get those big 1-hit KOs, the big 1-hit KOs will be 320 HP. And the last up is the fusion energy, which you can only attach to a fusion Pokemon. If it's not attached to a fusion Pokemon, you discard it. While in play, this card provides every type of energy, but only provides one energy at a time. The Pokemon this card is attached to isn't affected by abilities from your opponent's Pokemon. So once again, another way to kind of shut down quick shooting Inteleon, and who knows what other abilities this will actually be very strong against it again in the future. Once again, we're a couple sets away from this card, but definitely very good against quick shooting Inteleon right off the bat, shutting that down. So it has that going for it. Immediately it's going to be shutting down that quick shooting Inteleon from getting those quick shooting pings in on whatever Pokemon you don't want them to get it on. Can only be attached to the fusion Pokemon, and it's basically just kind of a rainbow energy. And yeah, that does it. These are the fusion cards. I'm super excited. All these cards are very interesting, and I hope that keeps that trend keeps up. All these cards have some kind of viability behind them, or seem powerful enough to at least make some kind of deck around. You know, Dragapult is stage two, but the attack's pretty strong, so maybe you can make a cool stage two deck. Maybe it's not super competitive, but there's something there, as opposed to a lot of cards we see these days, I feel like, just don't have anything going for them. The bulk of cards don't have anything going for them at all. Hopefully we see more of this, and this isn't like all the good fusion cards we're gonna get when fusion cards release. Hopefully there's more to go with it, or maybe something else. Maybe they have another stamp kind of card to throw at us besides fusion. They gave us single strike, they gave us rapid strike, maybe they give us fusion, and also like I don't know, turtle cards or something. Put some kind of stamp on it. But yeah, that's going to do it for my thoughts on the new fusion cards. Coming at you guys soon with more content. Just like I said, a little bit burned out on PDCGO. Everything's a little bit stale and so on. So might not see you tomorrow, but hopefully see you soon. Peace.